Welcome to Grad Guidance, career tips and tools for graduate students. I'm your host, Allie Erk, Associate Director of Graduate Student Career Development at Lehigh University.
This episode, A Professor's Perspective on Networking, features Professor Michael Lehman, Director, the Master's in Engineering Program in Technical Entrepreneurship, and Professor of Practice in the Department of Mechanical Engineering and Mechanics in the PC Rossin College of Engineering and Applied Science.
Welcome to Grad Guidance. I'm Allie Erk. Today our guest is Professor Lehman. Welcome.
Hey, Allie.
Thank you so much for being here. Wanted to start with just learning a little bit more about your current role and your professional background.
At Lehigh University, I am director of the Master's in Technical Entrepreneurship Program, a master's degree in the PC Rossin College of Engineering and Applied Science. And I'm also a professor of practice in the Department of Mechanical Engineering and Mechanics. Now, much like many individuals you encounter in your career, my background's a mix. My undergrad degree, a bachelor in the sciences. I have an MD, a medical degree from Penn State College of Medicine, and an MBA from the University of Leeds in England. And that all really leads to having a pretty wide network across the country and across the world. And much like you as grad students will develop through the studies you had as undergrads, wherever you went, and then your work at Lehigh and your career as you graduate from Lehigh, you're gonna have a network that builds and grows. And the conversation today, as Ali has asked me to talk about, is how you purposefully build and grow that network as you're going through your grad school program.
You have a wealth of experience to draw on as we talk about networking. So I wanted to start with thinking about your program at Lehigh. You utilize class assignments to help your students focus on networking. I was wondering if you could describe these assignments.
One of the assignments students get in the fall semester is called the Golden Rolodex. Now, I must say that some students have shared that this was one of the most favorite assignments they've had as a grad student, and others have said this is the most dreaded assignment that they ever faced. Many of them eventually come around and say that they've learned the most from this assignment. So wherever you fit on that continuum, the important thing about the Golden Rolodex is purposefully expanding your network. For example, students are challenged with developing a compelling LinkedIn profile, and we all know that technology evolves and changes. So what's LinkedIn today might be something different 2 or 3 years from now, but the same concept is there, that you use that online presence to not just be social with friends, but also to build that professional network. The second challenge is for students to connect with and have a conversation with 10 individuals they've never met before the beginning of the semester. And it might seem a little broad and daunting at first. For the purposes of this assignment, we give them categories. For example, another master's student at Lehigh, a PhD student at Lehigh, a graduate of the university, someone in your industry of interest, or someone who's connected to a family member. So it kind of gives you some guiding frameworks that you can start to expand that network rather than just blindly feeling like you have to go meet new people. The next important aspect of the assignment, which any of you as a grad student can replicate on your own, is to meet 3 of those individuals for a second time. So now you start to reinforce that when you meet someone for the first time in networking, you don't have to have an hour-long conversation. You don't even have to have a 20-minute conversation. 5 minutes, 10 minutes is often enough to find out who you are, what your background is, what your career pathway and trajectory is, and then you connect up on a social media platform. So now you've got someone in your network that you can follow up with when the time is right for either party. That follow-on second meeting is important. 3 of the 10, picking ones that you wanna have additional discussion with, whether it's in person or via Zoom or one of the other video platforms. And then you can start to delve into more specifics of how you can kind of learn from one another and support one another, you know, throughout your career.
There's so many aspects of this assignment that I think are just fabulous in helping students to take those steps, those first steps. So I love that they're finding 10 individuals, but then also that there's a focus on maintaining some of those connections and following up. I think that's really critical. So you had mentioned that for some students, this may have been, they may be more apprehensive about this assignment, and given everyone has different levels of comfort with networking. So I'm wondering what recommendations you would give to these students to help them.
The most important bit of advice is to have a warm introduction. And I'll give an example here. So let's say Allie comes to me and says, I'm really looking to connect with someone in the ed tech entrepreneurship space. Do you have someone to whom you could introduce me? And I scavenged my network. And actually, I thought of someone that I really should connect you to. And that warm introduction facilitates that conversation because there's that mutual connection and it's someone that's referred. So the person I'm actually thinking of, I could say, here's someone who's working in innovation in, career and professional development. And I think a conversation between the two of you would be mutually beneficial. So that warm introduction is really helpful to kind of grease the wheels of networking. Many students think that they have to blindly go out there and search LinkedIn or, kind of scan the environment and just network with someone out of the blue. And that's really tough to do. It's that warm introduction that's important. There are a number of ways that you can facilitate those connections. The first is family members, whether it's parents or siblings, whether they're older or younger than you, grandparents, extended family members. They all have their own professional and social networks. Making connections to them can be really beneficial. Friends is another great place for warm introductions. Now, you all have friends that you went to high school with, and they might be at schools outside of Lehigh. So there can be really cool ways for them to make connections in different cities and different geographies across the country. And then, of course, there's the Lehigh connection. And I've got the Lehigh logo on my shirt here. The Lehigh network is truly amazing. And there are a lot of platforms that Allie is familiar with and helps facilitate that you can reach out. So that Lehigh common bond is that warm introduction that you often need. And then the last thing to keep in mind, especially in the entrepreneurship space and the innovation space where I work, individuals are really eager to help young emerging talent. And time and time again, grad students say to me, I can't believe how much they were willing to talk to me or how long they were willing to share their experiences. So, don't hesitate to reach out. They want to give back, especially when they see like young, engaging minds coming out of grad programs. It's engaging for them as well.
So true. I think we have an exceptional Lehigh alumni network. I'm proud to be a part of it. And I'm glad that you highlighted that point. And I also love that you highlighted that we all have a network. And so tapping into your existing network and thinking about those second and third level connections of your network can really be powerful. So certainly you recognize the value of networking and you've incorporated that concept into your coursework. So I was wondering if you'd talk a little bit about what you see as the benefits of networking.
Throughout the years, I've seen graduate students that are starting companies land their first customer through networking. I've seen them land jobs if they're looking to, to actually go out and work in industry. I've seen people develop business-to-business relationships, supply chain partners, other connections that they make. The important thing to note is that failure will happen. For example, in Golden Rolodex, students may reach out to 20 people in order to make those 10 connections. And a lot of times, at first blush, you would say, well, why would someone not want to connect with me or talk to me? The simple answer is they're busy. They're just as busy, if not busier, than you are. And that's why you have to cast the net relatively wide. One analogy that is important to think about, imagine that you get an email or a message from a first year at Lehigh and says, you're an impressive grad student and would you be willing to sit down for an hour with me and tell me about your experience as a grad student? Now you may want to do that, but you may not have the time to do that. And the little message may all of a sudden start going lower and lower in your inbox or your chat feed or whatnot, and then you forget about it. So the same happens in the reverse when you reach out to professionals in industry. Nobody has like networking as part of their job description. It's just like a secondary thing that runs in the background. So what I recommend is making that barrier to entry, that threshold, really low. When you reach out through a warm introduction, say, do you have 10 minutes to hop on a Zoom call, or 10 minutes to hop on a phone call and have a conversation? So you make it really easy to say no, but you also give them a really manageable time chunk that fits into most people's schedules.
I think that's excellent advice to start off with, realistic expectations and to make a small ask in the beginning. I think that is truly helpful when you're forming those connections. So we talked a little bit about the benefits. I'm wondering if you could elaborate on some more suggestions or tips for students who really want to build their professional network.
Yeah. The best bit of advice I can give is something I do myself, and it's to set very specific and manageable goals. For example, you may say, I want to meet one new person every week, or you might say, I want to meet one new person to expand my network every month. And at first glance, you may say, well, that's not that many. But at the end of the year, that would be 12 new people that you've made a connection with. And chances are, of those 12, one a month, two or three are going to really stick, and you're going to develop a relationship that continues. So in a way, it's your own golden Rolodex, you know, one a month for the next year. So I challenge you to think about that. The other great way to increase your network is when you attend events, whether it's a guest speaker on campus, whether it's an industry event, a conference, an online Zoom event that takes place. And many online events are now starting to use technology for networking opportunities afterward. What I encourage you all to do is, before you leave that event, meet two new people. And again, that conversation can be less than 5 minutes long, but you're making that connection. When an event is over, or a guest speaker or whatnot, you know, most of us are like, we've got a list of 20 other things we got to do, and you want to hightail it out of there. But it's really important to remember that specific goal and say, two new people before I step out of that door, or, you know, head out of that Zoom room. And those connections you then connect up with on social media, and then increases the probability that the network will expand from there.
Yeah, I think that's excellent insight. Certainly, leveraging opportunities to make those connections and also having a plan for follow-up is really going to help build your network. And that's something here in the Career Center too, we can support students with, whether that's through your LinkedIn profile or sending your networking messages, we're here to support you along the way. So there's been so much great tips that you've given already, but I'm wondering if there's any last words of wisdom that you want to pass on to students on the topic of networking before we wrap up.
Yeah, just to recap three main points: get those warm introductions from people in your network already, have very specific goals, and then lastly, remember that networking is a two-way street. What you're learning and gaining from the other individuals, they're also learning and gaining from you. And then finally, leverage the great resource you have with Ali Irk, and leverage the Center for Career and Professional Development at Lehigh, which is an amazing resource that you should all be continually tapping into throughout your grad school experience.
I appreciate so much all of those key pieces of advice that you've shared, especially sharing all the wonderful ways you support your students. And I think that following up and showing appreciation and really paying it forward. So if you have opportunities to help others and to make introductions, I think it is so important. So I'm glad that you talked about that. Thank you so much, Professor Lehman, for being a guest. Really appreciate your time and all the wonderful advice and strategies you shared today with students.
All right, thanks.
Tune in next time to Grad Guidance for career tips and tools for graduate students, and we'll be talking about topics that are important to graduate students.
If you're interested in TE's Golden Rolodex networking assignment, create your own assignment to try. Develop a compelling LinkedIn profile. Connect with 10 individuals you have never met. Meet with 3 of the individuals for a second time. Don't forget these networking tips. Get warm introductions from those in your network and set goals for yourself. Remember, networking is a two-way street. and utilize Lehigh's resources and career support from CCPD. To learn more about Lehigh's TE program, visit the link below. Start networking with Lehigh alumni. Go to Lehigh Connects and explore 3,700 plus Lehigh alumni and growing daily who are available to provide career insights and support. Also, check out the Lehigh alumni page to find alumni on LinkedIn to connect with. Visit the links below for more information.